I'll just share that one. It is a structural audit of railway bridges. Structural audit of railway bridges. I will just put that.
Dr. Ingle Ramakant?
Yes.
Kishan Singh.
So you, yeah. Yeah, sorry for that. Your full name.
No, you can just put R.K. Ingle. Okay.
Okay.
How many participants have joined?
Ma'am, it is not showing.
It's not showing. I think we should wait four. For 5 to 10 minutes as we do it every time.
I think only four so far.
Yeah, because generally the participants also, they take 5 minutes or 10 minutes when we are giving them the time of 5 o'clock.
So, many of you have so.
Yes.
Good evening, Harsha.
Good evening, Ravindra. Good evening, sir. Good evening, English sir.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, Jyoti. Rui, how are you? You can't hear me, Rui. IRC meeting on Exodus Bridges. I told them to close the meeting and come and join this one. Then they wanted to know if they have to pay, etc. I said, go to the website, pay and join. So, Rui, you might get some more late attendees, including Professor Tandon and Alok Bhaumik and all my other bridge engineering friends. So, they might join now. I'm not sure. Just see.
Sir, can I do the broadcasting?
I think yes.
Okay.
Hello.
Good evening, Devte sir.
Good evening. Good evening, ma'am. Good evening. So, all have joined? Hello. Hello. Have our colleague joined?
Yes, sir. And few members will join later.
Okay.
Good evening, sir.
Should I begin?
Harsha ji, can we start?
Yes, sir, are you okay to wait for a few minutes? We've got participants are increasing.
Yeah, how many? 45 are there already.
Yeah.
Okay.
So just give 2 minutes and then we start.
Okay.
Then wait for another 2-3 minutes.
Yes.
Hello. Hello.
Hi, yes, Devte sir.
No, we can wait for another 2 minutes, 2-3 minutes and then start, I said.
Yeah, that's what I also suggested. Let the participants join.
Yeah, okay. Subharao Sahab, Namaskar.
Namaste, Devte Sahab. Namaste, namaste.
Namaste.
How are you, sir?
Namaste. How are you? Everybody, thank you. I'm all fine.
How is the weather in Nagpur, Dr. Ingle?
It is a little bit cold.
Huh.
Yes. But it is a good, pleasant.
Good, good.
Yes.
Good, good. Yesterday I was in Mathiran for the past 4-5 days. A very dear friend has a big bungalow at the end of One Tree Hill. You know, at the other end of Mathiran Plateau, about an hour and 45 minutes from the Dasturi. You have to walk. So I was there for the past 5 days. Very nice weather in the evening and mornings, up to 14 degrees.
Uh-huh.
Nagpur must be even colder than that, no?
Yeah, it is around 10, 11 like this.
My wife's family, since we are waiting, I'll fill you on some anecdotes. My wife's family, I'm married to a Parsi lady and my wife's family are all from Nagpur, you know. You might be very familiar with Gimi, Jal Gimi, the late chancellor of the university.
Yeah.
So my wife's family is Gimis. Yeah, they're all Gimi and Wardia. Yeah,
okay.
Gimis and Wardias. So yes. Jal uncle was very close to us and when we were growing up. And I mean, my wife and me later. So every year they have a lecture also. I've attended two of them. Every year they give me lecture.
I think his name was Jalpi Jimmy, you know?
That's right. That's
ah, yes, yes, correct, correct. Yes.
So we have also huge connection with Nagpur from my wife's side. And I used to deal a lot with P.T. Masay Saab when he was there. And Mr. A.M. Shingare and others, all good, very fine people.
Yes, Mr. A.M. Shingare, he's there. He's
very fine person.
Very fine. A good company.
Very good. Successful. Yes.
Yes.
Also.
Correct.
It is already 76 now. Can we start?
I think we should go to.
We are 51
broadcast.
Now.
Yeah. I'll mute all of us. Who's going to speak? Ravindra, you are leading, right?
So I will start. I will give the welcome. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. Good evening, everyone. I, Ruhi Agarwal, welcome you all for our special lecture. 14 series on the topic Review of Structural Audit of Railway Bridges by Dr. R.K. Engle. Now, I would like to introduce our Director General of IIBB. Engineer D.J. Dutte graduated in Civil Engineering from College of Engineering, Pune in 1974. Through 1975 UPSC exam, he joined Indian Railway Services of Engineering as Class 1 Officer and retired as Principal Chief Engineer of Indian Railways in 2011. During his service, he worked on many important railway infrastructure projects. He occupied the important post of Principal Chief Engineer, Any Railway and Southwest Railway, Director Board Member, Konkan Railway Corporation, Chief Engineer, Konkan Railway Projects, Chief Project Manager for Tunnels of Mumbai, Pune Expressway, Project Director of Katra to Luni, Project Portion of Udhampur, Baramulla JK, J. Jammu and Kashmir Railway project. Recently, he was on Mumbai Metro 3 to 33.5 kilometer long fully underground metro construction projects at CGM. Now, I would like to call our Director General for saying a few words.
Hello. Am I audible? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Good afternoon, everybody. We are here for today's special lecture. As you know, IIBB is Institute of Bridge Engineers, formed in 1889 by engineer Mr. M.C. Bhide, who retired as Chief Bridge Engineer of Indian Railways. And he had a dream of forming a special institute solely dedicated for bridge engineering issues. So he discussed this issue with all very senior field engineers, design engineers, field contractors who were in the field of bridge construction, and then decided to form this institute. Since this was formed in 1989, since then we had number of seminars, conferences, roundtable discussions, and so many programs to dissipate the knowledge available in this country and even outside the country on the subject of bridge engineering. The objective of forming this institute was to collect the collect the knowledge of bridge engineering regarding construction, maintenance, operations, retrofittings, etc. Collect the knowledge, store it, and disseminate to all the engineers, right up to grass level engineers who are working in the field. With this objective, the more than 29,000 pages literature, technical literature, has been collected, and that has been maintained in the library of IIB. Every year there is an annual function, annual bridge seminar on various topics. We also conduct the special function of awarding the outstanding bridge award. The purpose is to recognize the best work done by the engineers. In that, the department is recognized, the construction company is recognized, the design engineer is recognized, and the architect of the associated with the bridge, or the all engineers who are associated with the bridge, are recognized and appreciated their good work. Similarly, after this work was continued by Mr. Bhide for almost about 28-29 years. After his demise in the year 2018, the organization was revived and named Zeal and Enthusiasm. During last 1 year, during the year 2020, because of this pandemic situation, it was not possible to come together and conduct the annual seminar. So we thought of alternatives possible. So we organized the full-fledged seminar through webinar, and it was a quite success. Then we started special lecture series on various topics, and are benefited. So today is the 14th in this series, and Dr. Ingle is going to present his audit review on Indian Railway bridges. Indian Railway bridges are more than 160 years old, and all types of bridges are there. In that, stone masonry, brick masonry, RCC, PSC, steel girders, and different foundations, all types of bridges are there, and they are still holding on. We, Indian Railways, have changed the loading conditions, loading pattern. We changed the speed. We increased speed from 60 to 70 miles. So we have now come up to 140 kilometers per hour, and dedicated from freight corridor with very high load at the speed of 140 kilometers per hour. So under this changed circumstances and changed loading patterns, it is very essential to know the strength, the health of the bridge. And that is why Indian Railways have conducted the audit, structural audit of all the bridges. On that, Dr. Ingle will throw the light. He will tell us how they have gone about, and what are their observations, and how the leftover life of each bridge for these revised conditions have been worked out. He will throw light on that. It will be quite interesting. I welcome him, and request the organizers to take it further. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your gracious words. Now, I would like to introduce our president, honorary secretary, and moderator. Engineer Vire Gupta is a civil engineer from BITS Pilani in 1983 batch, and director and CEO in MSS Tandon Consultant Private Limited. His specializations are in bridges, flyovers, underground and elevated metro structures, precast building, 275-meter chimneys, etc. Active member of various courts committee of BIS and IRC. His contribution include preparation of IRC SP65, IRC SP71, etc. Recipient of several awards from IEI, IBC, and UCRI. He has been lecturing as guest faculty in IEA, HEIN, CRRI, CIDC, ISDA, DPC, etc. Engineer Gupta is the All Indian President of IIBE, Indian Institution of Bridge Engineers, and ICR, Indian Institute of Introduce. Dr. Gopal Rai holds a PhD from IIT Bombay. His phenomenal level of progress has enabled him to be associated with several prestigious projects, including the Apsara Reactor, BARC, Mumbai Airport Bridge Strengthening of Mithi River, ESIC Hospitals, JNPT, ROB Bridge, and many more. He is an honorary secretary of IIB, General Secretary of Association of Structural Rehabilitation and Retrofitting, Committee Member of ISSC, BIS, and ACI. He delivered 680 presentations nationwide and 27 presentations in international conferences. He is also a keynote speaker and author in 4 international conferences and more than 10 national conferences. Dr. Gopal Rai has a colossal research profile as well. More than 100 numbers of his research papers have been published in journals. Dr. Gopal Rai got the award for 50 Manufacturing Innovative Leaders at World Innovation Congress Award 2019. Also in Dubai for 40 Most Influential Leaders Under 40 Years 2017-18 by Asia One and many more. Engineer Swapnil Joshi at Intellect, who possesses Bachelor's in Civil Engineering and double post-graduation from United Kingdom and NICMAR with specialization in construction project management along with law graduation. He has wide exposure in developing systems, has developed expertise in the field of CPM combining technical and latest management tools such as Primavera, ASTA, Power Project, Telos, etc. He initiated and developed a mobile application, Intendo Projects, for daily monitoring and real-time data analysis of projects. With successful implementation of digitalized integrated approach and his expertise in project planning, BIM, and advanced technologies, is able to deliver the client's work successfully. Swapnil has been rewarded by Indian Institution of Bridge Engineers from the hand of Shri Nitin Gadkari in 2014. Now, I would like to introduce our moderator. Shri Ravindra Kumar Goel is an IIRC officer of Indian Railways in 1918 batch. He has long experience of design, fabrication, construction, and maintenance of railway bridges. During his long working at BNS DTE, of RDSO, he has worked on various projects with different IITs, devised the fatigue provision IRS steel bridge code, and developed guidelines of specific design of railway bridges. He holds a special diploma in bridge engineering from SS Rambol, Denmark. As chief bridge engineer of Central Railway, he has been dealing with approvals of design and drawings for road over bridges. He has issued comprehensive guidelines for design, fabrication, inspection, and maintenance of FOBs on Central Railway. He is also associated with IIBE since long and has presented several papers in his seminars. Now, I would like to hand over the session to our moderator. Thank you.
Thank you, Ruhi. So, it's my pleasure to introduce Dr. R.K. Ingle, Department of Applied Mechanics, VNIT Nagpur, for our special lecture series, lecture number 14, on the topic of review of structural audit of railway bridges. In railway language, we call it third-party structural audit. So before I give a formal introduction of our learned speaker, Dr. R.K. Ingle, I would like to give some background of this work of structural audit. As our Honorable Director General has told, Indian Railway has got more than 160, 170 years of old bridges. And Central Railway being the oldest railway, it has got plenty of them. Out of about 150,000 bridges, a good population, say 20%, might be older than 100 years. So maintenance of old bridges and their schedule of inspection requires a special consideration. And realizing this fact, Railway Board has permitted Zonal Railways to go for third-party structural audit of selected bridges wherever the railway engineers feel some kind of a doubt. And moreover, it was an attempt to involve educational institutes, IITs, VNITs, and other such private consultants to interact with railways and to understand how the railway bridges are maintained and certified for safety. So as a first step, Central Railway has taken the major decision and they selected 34 such bridges. And out of 34 bridges, 16 such bridges were given to VNIT. These 16 bridges involved 5 ROBs and 11 railway bridges. Most of the railway bridges were, I think 100%, all railway bridges were of steel girders. So now I introduce Dr. R.K. Ingle. He is a professor, Department of Applied Mechanics, VNIT Nagpur. He is a very competent professor. He has guided 77 M.Tech projects, 8 PhDs, and 1 PhD is ongoing. He has various international and national publications to his credit, 25 international papers and 31 national papers. And besides that, he had attended and presented papers in 30 international conferences and 27 national conferences or workshops or seminars. So he has got a great passion for structural design analysis of bridges, and particularly for railway bridges. This work, he has taken keen interest. He has visited many bridges more than once to assess properly. So I will not take much time now. Now I hand over the session to Professor Ingle for his presentation on review of structural audit of railway bridges.
Thank you, Goel sir.
thank you, yes. Goel sir, and thank you, Dr. Ingle sir. This is Dr. Rai.
Yeah.
I think, Professor, before you start, Dr. Engineer Goel sir has praised you a lot. And he told that your auditing should be set a benchmark for all the bridges audit. So with that kind of high spirit, all the best. And please, sir, you are welcome.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Okay, shall I start?
Sure, sir.
Goel sir? Okay. I'm just sharing my screen. First, I will come to my PowerPoint presentation. This is a brief presentation which I have prepared. Okay. And as said by Goel sir, we have received this 16 bridges from railways. I have summarized them into 3 categories. There were 5 bridges on, these are girder type, span around 18 to 20 meter. Sorry. Then there were 4 bridges which are of truss type and mixed type. These are unique bridges, they are totally different, like this Jaripatka Loha Bridge, Ajneer ROB and Mominpura. These are totally different bridges. So I'll be sharing my experience of one bridge in detail of these 3 types and then briefing about others. Of course, while doing this work, our main aim was to have a good procedure and good report for this. Okay. Whatever work we have done, I will be presenting that. There is some work still in balance. Okay. Means it is not complete yet because of this pandemic. We could not visit the bridges, which we will start by next month again. Okay. And maybe by 2 months, within 2 months, we'll be finishing everything because major work is over. So I'll be sharing only those points right now, which we have done the work. Now, out of this plate girder type bridges, these are 5 bridges: Dham Bridge, Kristana Bridge, Konda, Vardha Bridge, and Nag River Bridge. Okay. Now, out of that, whatever work we have completed is, first is visual observation, which we suggested, and immediate and long-term suggestions were given, photographs with comments, everything was submitted that time. Then structural checking. See, major bridges, no drawings were available. So we have measured all the elements of bridge and we have created drawings for this, structural drawings, okay, up to ground level. Because we cannot, we didn't wanted to take any risk by opening foundation. Okay, so up to that level, up to ground level, we have put our all the dimensions and we have created structural drawings. Then we have called, see that time, maybe 150 years old, there are many bridges. I will show you those year of construction also. We have calculated moments and shear and all forces with 25 ton loading as given in by IRS. Then a new thing which we started checking also, this frequency calculations. This is given in Eurocode, okay? And as my experience, like many of you, those who are doing bridge design, now IRC 112, it is just miss, it is same code as a Eurocode for RCC design, okay? So maybe tomorrow we may get this frequency check also in our calculations. So we try to include that also here. We have checked bracings also, because in between two girders, steel girder, plate girders, there are bracings. So that also we have checked. Substructures we have checked for dead load, live load, and earthquake. What we have observed that for substructure, earthquake is critical load as compared to wind load. So we have taken earthquake load for substructure, but bracing and other things, superstructure, we have checked for wind also. Then we have done certain instrumentation also on that. Vibration test we have done to measure dynamic displacement as well as frequency at that particular point. Okay. Wherever there is a concrete element, okay, we have taken NDT results also for that, and we have cross-checked the grade of concrete also in that. Then we have done fatigue analysis also. Okay. Now there are some two, three things missing here, which we have yet to start, or we have yet to do that one. One is quantity estimation, because as per railway contract, we have to give the quantity estimation also, whatever suggestions we are making. And second is load rating of these bridges, okay, which will come at the end, okay. So up to this, all this work we have done, okay. Now I will just try to share one report completely, okay. This is a Dham bridge. You can see this is a masonry structure. And you can see here, this is a upstream side where we have got this circular nose here. And here, since downstream side, it is a flat. It is a all masonry structure, okay? With bearings and bed block and superstructure. Now here, year of substructure of construction is 1867. Yes, for downstream and 1921 for upstream bridge. Means it is almost 100 to 150 year old. This bridge is six spans of 19 meters center to center. It is of steel plate girder bridge, UCR piers and abutment and bearings. Then steel superstructure. Again, it was placed on 1913 and 1917. So you can see this structure. After visiting this bridge, we don't feel any problem. Okay. Though it is more than 100 year old. Because masonry, as I have seen some of the references in UK, there are masonry bridges, masonry piers, abutment of more than 200 year old and still they are doing well, okay? So this is the beauty of this masonry structure, okay? this is our few photographs which we have taken, okay, to give some certain immediate suggestions, okay. Of course, in our report, what happens, we have placed the arrow here and we have said that, okay, this is a problem here. This nut is not tightened properly and so on. Okay, miscellaneous things. Okay, so we can see here, this type of thing. This is a photograph and this is a comment of that. Major structure crack is observed in the bed block here. Okay, see, our observation is that recently they have changed the bearings, but before that, maybe because of that impact or anything, this bed block might have got damaged. Okay, so there are certain cracks here, okay, which are visible. Some repair is been done here. Okay, some repair is also done. Okay, but it needs further repairing. Then even RCC jacketing is done for 2 piers out of other 5 piers, and 3 piers, I think they are going to take up later on. Okay, which is P3, P4, P5. Since foundation details are not available, see, all the bridges, we don't have any foundation detail. But then what happens, we have checked, is there any tilting or is there any settlement with respect to this tube? Okay, and we have observed almost all bridges. There was no sign of any settlement or anything. So with that observation, we are assuming that our foundation is sound and good. Okay, of course, that is our assumption. Unless we open it, it is impossible to see anything. Okay, but if there is some problem with foundation, it would have shown the results at the top. Okay, so there were few cracks observed, but not so serious. Okay, which we have asked in our first report to go for a epoxy grouting of those few cracks which are in bed block. Okay, there were certain vegetations which we have observed. We noted that also, and we said to remove that particular vegetation. Okay, you can see like this. Okay, so all these type of photographs. Okay, so that for each one, like P1, P2, P3, P4. Okay, and its problems we have listed. So one, without going into site, he will be able to understand what need to be done. Okay. This is a drawing which we have prepared. There are two girders, plate girders. One is upline and one is downline. Okay, these are the plate girders. These are all dimensions of this plate girder. And these are the pier dimension, as I say, nosing. And here it is a flat on other side. Okay, so up to ground level, whatever is a base level we could go. Okay, we have taken dimensions up to that, and below, since there is no visibility of any structural damage because of settlement, okay, we are presuming that foundation is good. Okay, so all these drawings were prepared, measured and prepared by us. Then what happened, this particular, it is a simply, this is a very simple structure basically. It is a simply supported girder. We tried to, we have calculated the total load as per 25 ton loading of IRs. Then we calculated the moment. Assuming it has simply supported, moment is nothing but only WL square by 8 and shear force is WL by 2. We have checked it. Okay, with respect to IRS code, now you can see here, stress coming is only 92 Newton per mm square, as against 158, which is permissible. Even this, we have cross-checked with respect to even IS 800 also, out of our academic interest. And there also, what we have observed, it is quite safe. Okay. Of course, this, whatever W we have calculated, it is including impact factor and some additional load for sleepers and other things. we have calculated the wind, because these bracings need to be designed for wind forces, this direction, okay, including this also. And all these bracings, they were checked for wind forces. Then this dynamic analysis. Basically what happens, suppose this is a pier and total mass. Generally, this is a very simple expression given in code also. T is equal to 2 pi root delta by z. Delta is a displacement at the top because of horizontal force, and m is lump mass. A very simple mathematical model, but may not be correct for all types of things. Now you can see here, much better we can do nowadays with availability of software. We can go for multi-degree of freedom system instead of going for single degree of freedom system. But for this calculation of this, we have used simple one because we wanted to have our report simple and understandable to all also. So for this girder bridge, we try to use this particular expression also along with the analysis by software. Frequency calculation, you can see frequency for simply supported case. This A and B, we can have these two values. And we get frequency in vertical direction for a simply supported bridge. If it is a fix, it is A and B will be this one. If it is a cantilever, this it will be this one. In our case, it qualifies for this, okay, most of the cases. Okay, so we have adopted this particular formulation with A and B 6.93 and 0.48. Okay. Now the significant, there is another formula also, very simple. Frequency is nothing but 18 divided by delta, where delta is in mm. Okay. Very simple. We can just use these particular expressions also for various things. Okay. Now this is what we got in Eurocode. Eurocode recommends for road bridges. If it is a road bridge, not railway bridge, very simple formulation is there, span by 100 should be our frequency. Okay. Means our frequency has to be more than span by 100. Okay. Of course, if you want to have conservative side, it will be L by span by 100 plus 0.5 hertz. Okay. Many references, they give only span by 100. Okay. Now, in case of railway bridges, two limits are given. Upper limit as well as lower limit. Okay. Now you can see what is recommended is our bridge frequency should fall in this particular zone. Otherwise, we have to go for detailed dynamic analysis. That is what suggested in Eurocode. Even for foot bridges also, frequency is mentioned as minimum frequency 5 hertz. Many times what happens, even foot bridges also we get for scrutiny purpose. But many of designers, they don't check the frequency. Okay. I think this also, all this frequency, of course, footbridge frequency, it is mentioned in the code. But these two, they are not there in code. But we are adopting this. Means whatever now flyovers being constructed in Nagpur, we are using this particular limit. We are suggesting on PWD also, for road bridges, let us have this particular limit. Our frequency has to be more than that. And for railway bridges, we have checked with respect to this now. Now, for this particular Dham bridge, frequency is calculated. Okay. Now, you can see here, for this particular span, lower limit is 4.24 hertz and upper limit is 10.5 hertz. And we are getting 10.6 hertz, which is quite close to this maximum limit. Okay. So that's why we say that it is okay, because it is on the boundary. Okay. Then this super substructure also we have checked for static load, lie load, as well as earthquake forces in both the direction. Okay. These are some calculations which are shown here. I'm not going into detail of this, okay? But just to inform that, okay, dead load, live load, and earthquake forces we have considered to check the stresses at this particular level, okay? Because in the absence of foundation, because since foundation is not known, we could not check the stability, sliding, or any other things, okay? Then there were two piers where jacketing was done, two piers and one abutment. We have checked the strength also at that particular point, and you can see the strength was more than M25 on average, okay, which was good. Okay, this equipment we have used for this DG Smith hammer, okay, for checking the strength. Then dynamic analysis also we have done using this particular equipment, FFT analyzer. Okay. Now we can see here the frequency. Now this frequency is 4 hertz. It is less because what happens, that frequency, whatever we have cross-checked at this particular point, it is only free vibration frequency without any live load. Okay. Now this is with the, when it is a good strength, because whenever we, when it is good strength, our load will be increased. Okay, so our margin increases. Okay, so our frequency also decreases in that particular case. So you can see we are getting 4 hertz there for good strength and 4.5 hertz for passenger train. Okay, and this indicates that good strength, since it is having more load, frequency is less. Okay. This is on one span, then we have checked again. Okay, just to cross check again. So it was 4 hertz and 4.5 hertz again. Okay, with little bit variation in acceleration and dynamic displacement. You can see dynamic displacement, it was just 3.2 mm peak to peak. Okay, means what happens, our this vibration will be, this displacement will be like this. So peak to peak, it is only 3.2 mm, okay? So that's why this structure is quite rigid, okay? Because it can be seen from this particular frequency calculation also. It is having frequency 10.6, it means it is quite rigid, okay? And it is reflected with this experimental also. Then apart from that, we have done fatigue analysis, okay? See, there are so many 11 trends which are suggested. Out of that, we have taken few trends, around 5 trends we have taken. Okay. See, it is mentioned here. Train number one, this one. Train number 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, and 8. These trends we have taken. For each train, this is given by in IRS code, okay. For each train, we have calculated the maximum moment by running the complete train. We have calculated the maximum moment, shear force, and from that we try to calculate the stresses and check the this fatigue analysis for that. Okay, so it is 70, which is less than 78, is okay. Okay. Now, out of that, this also, we were little bit conservative. We have taken this particular stress, though higher one is also permissible for this particular case. Okay. But we wanted to see the extreme thing. Okay. So with this also, it is safe. Okay. Now, I will just cover other bridges also. This is Nag Bridge at Nagpur. You can see there is a road here. This two lanes road is there, and other three spans. These three spans, it is a nala. Okay. Now what we have observed is superstructure of this two particular span is quite good, but there is a lot of corrosion in this particular zone. Okay, so this was our superstructure, cross section of that with bracings and other things, and this is our launch floor section. It is a 5-span. This 2-span is road bridge here. There is a road here, and this is a nala. Okay, this is nala. Okay, we have observed some corrosion here. Now, to check that corrosion effect, many of us may be remembering earlier that 1.5 mm corrosion allowance was there in IS 800. So we thought, let us apply that corrosion allowance here also, okay, and try to check the structure with corrosion allowance. See, stress is like this, 158, because it is a maximum limit. Okay, even we have checked with as per IS 800 also, because since we have taken that clause from IS 800 earlier one, so it is coming. See, this should be less than one interaction factor. It is coming 0.93 as per IS 800. Though we have to use IRC, this particular margin is much more with IRC code. Okay, so even assuming that 1.5 mm reduction in the cross section, also it is, this bridge is safe. This is Kistana bridge. Again, you can see similar. Okay, masonry. Okay, same thing, only masonry dimensions are different. Okay, this is a Konda bridge. This is a, one is up down upline and another is downline. Okay, and these are the piers. See, with so much thing, we could not observe any settlement effect or anything like that. Okay, all the piers were quite straight. Okay, this is a structure drawing for Konda bridge. Okay, this is a Wardha bridge at Pulgao. For this bridge, basically all the piers, they were jacketed. Okay, jacketing is done for all the piers. Okay, so it was just looking like a new bridge when we visited this particular bridge with very good painting and other things. Okay, so this is the dimensions and drawings for that. Okay, yes. Now, before going further, before going for truss type, I just wanted to give my comment on this particular bridge. See what happened nowadays, we get at VNIT, we get many bridges for cross-checking, or that is structural scrutiny, new bridges. Many designers, they use meticulously all this IRC as well as IRS codal requirement. But see, apart from that, we perform analysis on some mathematical model. Okay, so maybe what happens, sometime our mathematical model may have certain errors. Okay, let's say suppose this is a simply plate girder. Okay, we assume that our center line is here and our mathematical model will be something like this, a single line. Okay, what this means? This means, see, our support is here. Okay, but when we take mathematical model, our support being assumed at this particular point. Okay, there are many papers, okay, to address mathematical model of this. Okay, see, in mathematical model, we should apply our support at this particular point and not at this particular point, like is done here. You can see simply supported bridge, but still we are having certain assumptions. Sometime it may be on conservative side, sometime it may not be. So many times what happens, whenever we do any bridge design, we should always keep certain factor of safety. See, this particular bridges, whatever people they have designed 100 years back, today also I don't have any hesitations to say that under 10 to 20 years, nothing is going to happen to these bridges. Okay, if of course some maintenance is required. Okay, but they are so sound and good. Okay, I remember when we visited this particular bridge, I said, why the railway people, they have given us a new bridge for audit. Okay. It was looking such a nice. Okay. Because recently they have done this strengthening. Okay. Of course, this for all masonry structures, it is better to provide this encasing now. Okay. Just to increase its life. Now, after that, we have gone for this under set of bridges. These are four bridges. Wardha Bridge at Mazri, then Machna Bridge at Itarsi, Irai Bridge on Wardha Ballarsa section, and Una Bridge. Again, Vallar, it is near Hingangat, Wardha Ballarsa section. Now, here I will just brief about Una Bridge first, okay, because all other, they are similar. Though I will be showing their structured system is totally different for all the bridges. Okay. And many times what happens from this only we should say, my other suggestion is that I think railway, if they can publish a book on this superstructure of this truss type of bridges, definitely it is going to be very valuable addition to engineering fraternity. Okay, because you can see all these four bridges, their sections were totally different. Okay, and a very nice meticulously planned. Okay, let us see Una Bridge here. Again, we have gone through all this process. Okay, wherever possible. Okay, this is a structure you can see now, very good, well painted, painted and well maintained. Okay, it is 140 years old. Nobody will believe that it is a 140 years old structure. Okay, there were four spans of 45.72 meters span. Okay, it's an open steel truss bridge, UCR piers and abutment. Bearing replacement is done. Okay, and again, superstructure was put in 1935. Okay. These are some photographs we have taken, okay? Because what happens, see, whenever we do some structural audit, we try to find out the mistakes, okay? Okay, so we say that, okay, oh, because otherwise people will say no work is done, like there is some corrosion to the steel plate. We say that, oh, there is a corrosion here, okay? There is one stone which has come out little bit here. We say that, oh, there, see, there is a problem here. Some oil leaking and then some corrosion. Okay, see, small, small things, of course, not so problematic. Okay. So we have given our inspection report that time to suggest immediate measures. Okay, and again, a settlement, no settlement was observed. Okay. Some small rusting of, maybe suppose they clean it, it will not be visible. Okay. Rusting of this one, displace one stone like this. See what happened? We have given comments and we have given like this also, where that problem is there. Okay. Somewhere some notebooks are were missing and we talk with railway people also. They say it is in routine. They replace many things and check also. Okay. These drawings we have developed. Okay. Because these drawings were not available. We have measured all the members. Okay. It's whatever type, section type, its thickness, and everything. Okay. Its lacing. Okay. Its spacing. All these things were measured, and measured drawings were prepared. Okay. And then we have performed analysis also for this. This is, you can see, simple truss. Okay. Then we have, you can see the sections now. Okay. See, TB1 section, you can see here like this. TB2 section. Okay. Then this is under section here. This is TB3 section. okay, BT1, these are basically bracings, okay, BT2, TRB1, all these are sections. We have done measurement of this, thickness measurement and other things, and we have got these drawings, and then we have used these particular sections in our analysis. Okay, we have modeled this in SAP 2000. Okay, dead weight is placed and lie load, along with dead load of sleepers and other things, we have applied. Okay, as per IRS here as a simply supported case. Okay, and these sections are given. You can see here. This is a TB1, okay. This is TB1, this is IB1, and so sections are given here, okay. These sections which we have measured, they are coming here at this particular locations, okay. So we have done perform the analysis considering all these particular actual sizes. Deflections were calculated by software, okay. Dead load deflection, lie load deflection, total deflection, and it was seen, okay, with respect to the limit also. Okay, then member checking is also done here. I have shown only one member, let's say TB1. It has been checked since it was mainly an axial member. Okay, the axial capacity is checked here. Okay, this is total axial force and capacity is this much. Okay, so it is safe. Our interaction factor coming is 0.7. Now, while doing mathematical modeling, you can see here, if you see photographs here, these are almost rigid connections. So, because I remember, I have gone through one of the literature where it was mentioned that was a railway bridge in, I think, European countries, which has failed because of secondary effects, because they have done pin jointed truss analysis and checked only for axial forces. But here, apart from pin jointed, there will be a lot of moment generated, because this will not act as a pin jointed, because with so many bolts, okay, so many bolts, it is impossible that it will act as a pin jointed. So we have done analysis using beam elements directly. Okay, wherever simply supported is there, we have provided simply supported beams there with the internal hinge. All this is a truss, but it is a beam element, rigid connections, and we have got moment also. So this interaction factor we have calculated. You can see for this member, it is coming as a 0.7. Like that, in our design report, we have given this for all members. Okay, then we have performed dynamic analysis for this also. Okay, you can see frequency here, it is a 6 hertz frequency calculation. Okay, and as per Eurocode, minimum frequency is 2.43 and maximum is 5.4. Okay, limit, it is more than 6. What our assumption is, more the frequency means what, it is a quite rigid. So we have allowed this particular thing, okay. Only we would have raised our hands had it would have been lower than this. Okay. Then again, similar to earlier bridge, we have conducted fatigue analysis. We have taken all the trends, okay, with their axial load. We have calculated the moments and we have checked the stresses. Of course, from theoretical point, 79 is greater than 78. Okay, of course, from practical point of view, it is almost safe. But we wanted to suggest that such members which are on boundaries, it should be strengthened. Okay, that is going to come on our recommendation. Okay. We have checked the substructure also, again for dead load, lie load, and earthquake forces. Okay. Now here also, since we are getting in under earthquake case, we are getting little bit more tension here. Okay. So for many bridges, many piers like this, imaginary piers, we are suggesting encasing from 150 to 300 mm thickness. Then dynamic vibration test analysis is also done here. Okay, you can see frequencies 2.5 hertz here. With good strength, passenger train, it is 3 hertz for this particular one. Okay. And peak deflection, since span is more here, you can see 6 mm was peak displacement for this. Still within limit. Okay. It's quite a rigid structure. Same thing, similar thing we have done for Erai Bridge also. But in Erai Bridge, one thing was there was a lot of corrosion was there. So what we have done, whatever sections were there, okay, whatever sections we have measured, we have prepared their drawings, and then we have reduced the section by 1.5 mm to account for corrosion. Okay, we wanted to see what happens. Suppose it is corroded and it has reduced the thickness. Okay. So that we have done, and we have checked that also. Few members, okay, we are getting factor instead of one, it is 1.1, like that, with corrosion allowance. Okay, so in our final report, we were discussing with the railway people also, with corrosion allowance, because what happens to strengthen such members, it is not very difficult. Okay, we can very easily strengthen. Okay, what our suggestion was to have this interaction factor for all the member less than 0.85. Okay, because we wanted to have inherent strength of at least 15% in our design. Okay, so with this corrosion allowance, when we are getting like this, we say that okay, we'll go for strengthening of such members. This also, see what happened, we have not done corrosion analysis in this particular Una bridge, because we have not observed any corrosion in this particular bridge. It was well maintained, everything okay, it was colored, everything, no signs of corrosion except some plates like this. Okay, but superstructure, there was no corrosion. Okay, only this Erai bridge, since we have observed, even plate girder bridges also, only Nag bridge we have observed corrosion. So we have done that corrosion approximate analysis for corrosion by reducing the thickness only for Nag bridge, not for any other bridges. This Erai bridge, okay. Then this is a Wardha Manjri bridge. Now here, one peculiar thing we have observed. Okay, this is the first time. You can see here. See what happened. Generally, we were assuming that, see here, our assumption was it is a individual foundation. Because all other piers on other side, it is an individual foundation. But when we visited again second time, when water level was low, okay, see, you can see when water level is high, was high, we could not see this particular construction of pier. Here what happens, they have got two piles like this, very big piles. Then over that pile, this pier was constructed. You can see here. Okay. Nowhere we have seen it, okay, even not in references or anywhere like this. So this must be what we are presuming, that this must be well foundations, two wells, small diameter, and over that concrete is placed, and over that masonry pier is there. You can see with such a thing also, there is not a small indication of any settlement or any leaning of pier or anything. Okay, though high flood level is up to this level here. Okay, it is quite high flood level. Okay, and there is a considerable velocity also, it is a quite a big river. Okay, but this problem we have seen. Okay, in our recommendations, what we are proposing, okay, to have some concrete encasing for this particular thing, okay, we suggest that we should go 300 to 500 mm below and then provide complete encasing here, okay, so that further erosion should not happen and it should not endanger our bridge. Okay. But this we could see in our second visit only, okay, because we have to make sure that we are to check the foundation and other things. We do visit at different times, okay, when there is high water and when there is a very less water also. This is a cross section. It is an undersung bridge, okay. You can see bearing wear here, okay, and it's, you can see this. This is a, okay, I think, yeah, you can see this underslung bridge here, okay, and all cross sections, they were totally different. See, normally what happens in theoretical only, we see that tension member and compression member, they have provided very good cross section for compression member because L by R ratio has to be very low there. We have more strength, and wherever there is a tension member, it was quite slick member. Okay, this real engineering can be seen with this bridges which people they have done analysis that time. Okay. And you can see here analysis we have performed now using this SAP 2000 and this software. These people they have done 100 years back. Okay. No computer. I think that time even calculator were also not there. It may be slide rule or something like that. Okay. Okay. But you can see such a good structure and still usable. Okay. This is a Machna bridge on ETRC Amla section. Okay. This is one superstructure and the superstructures like this. Okay. This we have, see, no drawings were available. So we have prepared, we have measured each and every cross section. And then we have prepared the structure drawings. From structure drawing, this we have developed mathematical model. We have performed the analysis and we have checked each and every member. I remember one thing here, what has happened. This member dimensions, we have taken something wrong in our first visit. Then when we started doing analysis, this member was showing failure and drastic failure. Then I say, okay, if this member is there, this bridge is running since so many years, knows without any sign, there must be something wrong. Again, we have visited and we have cross-checked it, this member. Then we found that yes, while doing some measurement, okay, we have committed certain mistake. So in one go, it is very difficult to do anything on these bridges. Okay, this is superstructure. This is, sorry, the substructure. Okay, and now after this truss type and plate girder type, there were another type of bridges now here. You can see here. Jaripatka, Lohapul, Ajni, and Mominpura bridge. I will just browse through all. All methodology were same. We are, because what happens, we wanted to have our first methodology here. Okay. This was Jaripatka ROB. Construction was 1923. Okay. There was a road traffic. But quite early after construction of this bridge, because of some problem, okay, the road, this bridge was, traffic was restricted to very light traffic. Okay. Even today also only cars and very small light traffic, they move over this. Okay. There is a reason for that. Okay. Some damages they have observed here in abutment also and at this particular locations also. Okay. In our report, we have shown that. Okay. Then some strengthening measure also were done. Okay. But what we can see here, when we have prepared its mathematical model, dead load, seat deflection, we have calculated, you can see the deflections were quite high. 35 mm for only dead load displacement. Then lie load, if you take class A loading, 11, okay. Unit's frequency also, you can see it is a 2.2 hertz, it's very light, okay. So maybe because of that, there might have been certain deformations, okay. Because it is a road bridge now. As per this formula, frequency should have been more than 10.35 hertz. So our observation was the structure, superstructure was quite flexible. Okay, and that's why since long, heavy traffic was banned on this particular bridge. And now a new bridge is being constructed at this particular location, because our suggestion also was to replace this particular bridge. Then there's a Lohab full bridge. It is quite close to our railway station. Okay. It is like this. Okay. With central piers like this. Okay. We have checked this also. It is 100-year-old structure. But since it is a well-maintained, okay, apart from such small things which we have pointed out, otherwise, majority of portion, it is well maintained, okay, and it is quite strong today also, okay. Then these are the cross sections of these members. We have done, this is what will while testing, okay. Testing is done for dynamic frequency analysis of this. This is superstructure, okay. See what happened, it is a continuous like this, okay? Because it is connected at this particular point also. So it behaves just like a continuous, okay? So this is in plan, okay? Now, we have done the analysis also. You can see now, measured frequency itself is 7 and 9 hertz. That means it is a quite strong, okay? In fatigue analysis, you can see here, 85 is coming, but permissible is 78. But we are not bothered much on this because we have given reasoning for this also. Because here what happens, there are so many girders. Okay, there are many girders like this. Okay, when train comes on this, that rail will be something like this. So that rail load gets shared by 3 girders minimum. But we are assuming that only 1 girder is having complete this particular loading, which is very, very conservative. Okay. Then cushioning effect we have not considered. Okay. Whole train was considered only on 1 girder, that one wheel. Okay. Main girders were continuous, but we have assumed, we have done calculation for this 80, calculation of 85 as a simply supported. Otherwise, this also we are going to modify it, our next one. Okay, we'll go for continuous also. It will come much less. Because you can see this frequency analysis results itself, they show, indicate it is a quite rigid structure. Then Asni Arobi, this is something very unique. See what happens. It is having few span of masonry, then few span of continuous like this. Okay. Continuous up to 50, 60 meter, then continuous like this. This is also 92 years old, 18 span. So there are total 18 span. 3 hours type span of 10.15 meter, 15 continuous portal. Okay. Out of that, 4 are continuous, and last says 97 are continuous. Okay. And spans are 8.95 to 10.65. So one continuous will be there for 4 spans like this. like this, and last one is having 7 spans like this. Continuous. Okay. For this also, there were no drawings available. Okay. But you can see this masonry construction, stone masonry. We have done its analysis also using the available software. It was quite safe. Okay, that's why no distress was there from heavy traffic, because quite heavy traffic goes on this. But when we came to for this particular section, we have observed lot many cracks in this particular section at many locations. Some sections were already repaired. When we try to calculate, means for each frame, so this is one frame. Of course, this is simply supported on abutment here. So this is a 4 span. This is second 4 span girder with expansion joint between these two, like this. And then after this, there is one 7 span also. Okay. Now you can see, for this first frame, frequency was 3.25 hertz. Here 0.95 hertz, and here 0.92 hertz. Of course, this frequency we are showing for frame like this, not in vertical direction. See, vertical direction, it was quite rigid, and that can be seen from this one. You can see vertical loads. Okay, purely vertical loads, there is no problem. But as soon as there will be any lateral load, okay, especially suppose some heavy vehicle is moving and they are applying brakes, it may cause very heavy lateral force. Okay, you can see in that particular case, our structure is quite flexible. And that's why, see, there were cracks in this particular columns also. Even foundations also, we have seen some exposed foundation, they are having certain cracks. So for this, immediately what we suggested to limit the bridge to only medium vehicles, medium light vehicles. Okay. Or very heavy vehicles should be avoided. Okay. And railway, they have done that also. And there is a planning, because we have suggested, instead of any repair, because repair cost will be much, much high in this particular case if they want to go for this. Okay. It is better to replace it, a new one. And I think there is a proposal also. Okay. For replacing of this. Now, this is what we have covered, all the bridges here. Whatever work we have done, there is certain work which is still in balance. Okay. Because of this last 1 year pandemic situation, we could not complete that work. That is a load rating of each bridges, as well as whatever suggestions we have done. Okay, let's say, suppose in this particular member, we want to strengthen some member. Okay, how to do that? And its estimation. Okay, we are suggesting the strengthening of this also, encasing of this. Okay, with 150 to 300 mm thickness, then quantity estimation of this. These two things, is they are still in balance. Okay, so these two things we have done. This, apart from these two things, we have completed majority of things what we have thought. Okay, now even some of you people also might have done some other work apart from what we have done. Okay, I'll be very glad to hear that, and maybe we'll do that also here on this particular pages. Okay. This is one last bridge, which was Mominpura Arubi. It was a box section, okay, quite sturdy, apart from small, small repairs to be done. But the problem of this bridge was, it is quite narrow. Okay, you can see very small vehicle goes with that. Okay, so we suggested to have additional Arubi at this particular point. Okay. Even we have checked the compressive strength also, you can see it is quite high. Of course, this particular concrete, it was expected that it is M40 grade concrete, or at least M35, and it is satisfying that particular case. Okay. Then frequency analysis also we have done. Since it is a concrete, quite high frequency, we are getting here. Even displacement, you can see 0.3 mmR like that. Okay, thank you. If I'm just stopping here, sharing this one. Now, any further suggestions, or we can have some more discussions also here. At least presentation part I have completed.
I think.
Yes.
It's a wonderful presentation, Dr. R.K. Engle.
Okay.
So I would say it's a very comprehensive structural analysis that you have done so far. And I'm very happy that whatever we had thought, you have gone beyond that.
Yeah. But sir, I think, sir, Goel sir, I would like to say here, we got very good input from you also, sir. Because you remember two times we met at VNIT.
Yeah, actually.
Okay.
Yeah.
And very good input we got. And that led to us to have something additional and something good. Okay.
Good. So a big applause for Professor R.K. Engle for doing this wonderful analysis and giving a very comprehensive presentation.
Thank you.
And I would like, there are a number of questions also. But
okay.
Before I go for questions, I would just like to summarize, if you permit me.
Yes. Okay.
First of all, this is a complete thorough analysis, which has covered the aspects of dynamic analysis, static analysis, which was actually not intended when we defined the scope of this work.
Okay.
And you have done a very good job by creating the missing drawings of the structures.
Yes, yes. Because sir, without these drawings, we cannot go for any analysis.
Yes, that shows the kind of commitment that you have given to this work.
Yeah.
And then you have also gone for corrosion allowance.
Yes.
This is 1.5 mm that you have taken as per some standard practices.
Yes.
Reports. And then in case of foundations, of course, you could not see the foundation, but as a practice, we feel that if there is some problem in the foundation, the signs are seen in the substructure or the suprastructure.
Correct, correct.
So, but we have a different plan to go for mapping of unknown foundations wherever we are found, we are missing these plans.
Okay, okay.
So that is another different work. And then regarding Vardha Bridge, you have given the comment of pile and pile cap that you have discovered. Actually,
It is something new which I have not seen anywhere.
That's right. And that shows how great the engineers were at that time.
Yes, yes. No, I really salute all those people. Okay.
Yes. And one more thing you have commented about the no corrosion observed in Bonna Bridge. You have commented.
Yes.
Even after a service life of more than 100 years, that is a compliment for the maintenance engineers of
railway. Yes.
I would say. And then Mashna Bridge, you have pointed out a very good thing that the sectional dimension that you have taken initially, they have to be updated because
you
found some issue in during the
analysis. Yes.
And that is very important lesson to be understood, whosoever is doing this structural analysis, that they have to rely on the basic data.
Yes. Correct.
And you have mentioned something about the Loha Pool.
Yeah,
it is very well maintained. And then you have said fatigue may, there was some issue. There was some issue in the fatigue.
Yeah. Because what happens, our assumption was simply supported, though it is continuous.
That's right. But then you have said that actually the fatigue may 1.15 ka, we use the factor of gamma MF of 1.15 for the new designs.
Okay.
And that has to be more than one. At the design stage, it's okay. But when we are doing the analysis, we can reduce it up to 1.05 also.
Okay.
So if you do that, you will find it absolutely safe.
Correct.
So that is additional thing which I want
to add. Yes, definitely. Correct.
And then regarding ROB at Nagpur, stone masonry, you have said physically it was okay and you have done the analysis also.
Yes.
Software, and that is a wonderful job that you have done, I would say. And Mominpura, you have done the concrete strength testing also.
Yes.
Again, a very good job. And there are some questions regarding how these bridges have been selected for auditing, what was the need of structural auditing. So for them, I would like to just say that for selecting the ROBs, our criteria was number one age.
Yes.
because all these ROBs were constructed some 90-100 years ago.
Correct.
And
correct,
second thing is that as a practice, we all know municipalities, they keep on laying layers after layers on the road. So that yes. increases the dead load. So that is a increase in load. So one has to reanalyze what yes. is the effect of that.
Correct.
Then during inspection, routine inspection, we find that most of the expansion joints, they yes. are not working. So that adds to the stresses at some level.
Yes.
And footpaths, they carry the service loads like additional cables, pipelines.
Yeah.
So considering all these things, we decided that all the ROBs which are considered critical,
yes,
they should be covered in this third-party structure audit.
Yeah.
And for other railway bridges, the criteria was that all the important bridges having yeah. big spans, they yes. should be covered. And that gives a lot of confidence to our field engineers.
Yes.
After getting the reports from VNIT, I think they will be much yeah. more confident about the maintenance of these bridges.
Yes, definitely.
So with this, with these remarks, I would now go for the questions.
Yes.
If any of our panelists has to say something, I would request Dr. Surya Prakash, if you have to say something.
Yeah, I think it was a nice overview. I think always the condition assessment is a very yeah. difficult thing, especially for a very old bridge.
Okay.
My question was, when we try to calibrate these FE models,
yes,
we need to take some samples, you know, especially the steel bridges. At that time of construction, we really don't know what would be the grade of steel and the material properties. Are the coupon samples were taken and tested in the lab to?
No. Actually, what happened? We have written a letter to railways that time.
Yeah.
You give us some samples, but they have not given this one. Okay. Mm-hmm. So we have assumed it is Fe250 steel.
Okay.
Ha. But yes, as you say correctly. Like grade of concrete we are checking. So this also we have attempted.
Mm.
But for them also it was difficult which sample they should give. Okay. Yeah. Because cutting that main frame member and other things, it was really difficult. Okay. Mm. So we assume that it is Fe250 because earlier days mainly it was there, Fe250. Mm. And we have gone with the analysis and design.
Okay. So I think also one thing to note on is, you know, that allowable stress method that time, what it was practiced, they were really way over designed.
Yes.
Kind of helping us in maintaining this kind of, structural reserve capacity. Mm. Now, the moment we've gone to RFT design, I think the reserve margin has come down.
Yes.
That is the reason I feel the bridges, even after 100 years, that they're performing really well.
Correct.
And you're right, sir. Actually, there is a lot of reserve strength, and in the substructure, we have found there is a factor of safety of about 6.
Right.
Yes.
So that way, we are having a very good strength in the substructure. Yes.
I'm Dr. Goyal.
Yes, please.
I'm Hegde here.
Yeah.
I think rather than giving the credit to the reserve strength, I think we'll have to give the credit to this railway maintenance management team. I only hope that the maintenance which has been done by the railway sector has been done for even the highway bridges also. I have to really, congratulate Dr. Ingle, not only Dr. Ingle, even the railways of Indian Railways for having such a wonderful maintenance management system inbuilt into that. I've got a couple of questions to Dr. Ingle.
Yes, sir.
Now, very innovative way of checking the superstructure in the frequency domain. I really liked it. And you said that certain frequency ranges have been specified in the Euro codes.
Correct, yes.
And for the road bridges as well as the railway bridges.
Yes.
But how do you compare with the, you see, the thing is originally when the superstructures were designed by railways, perhaps those were not taken into consideration and it was done.
Yes.
Now, whether the structure has deteriorated or not on the basis of in the frequency domain, permissible frequency domain, how do you come to know? Because you don't know what frequency it was designed for in the first place, right?
Yes. It is difficult to know that. But what happens, if you see our results also, frequency results, they were quite comparable with our analytical results.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's why we are saying that our assumption of this is correct. because you can see when we have done, it is a free vibration analysis. There are no trends on that. Okay. But when we have done frequency analysis experimentally with the road trends, our mass increases. So our frequency reduces. So it shows. Okay. It gives that indication.
Thank you. Okay. Thank you, Dr. Engle. Yes. Now, Dr. Gopal Roy wants to say something. I would request him to kindly say.
Namaskar, sir. Bahut bahut dhanyavad.
Yes, Pali.
Or Professor Engle, I think you have taken the subject of audit from rebound MR ultrasound carbonation to natural frequency, to member analysis, to FEM part. I think this is what we want in audit. We should now, apart from doing the element and audit, or the localized audit, we should think about the member audit also.
Yes.
So really congratulations to you that we are talking on the forum of audit, not on the entity instrument and all. We are talking on the totality of globality of members. That is the best part.
Yes.
And as coming from a professor, so it make more authentic and more realistic. I will request that if you can come up with some small guidelines on the audit. Okay, and IAB will be willing to publish to all the members and all. So if you can come up with some small guideline, because a lot of we get from the bridge like railway, NHI and all. We can give some, like these are the modern way of doing audit of the bridges, guidelines, and these are the know-hows. If you can give us to us, we can circulate to all the institutions.
Very good idea, I think.
Definitely, but so, it has to be collectively, because I can prepare the draft.
Don't worry, we will be associated with
Yes.
Now I request Dr. Surya, Dr. Professor Jyoti Bhusari, if she has to say something on this. Yes. Madam, you are off. Muted, your mic is off.
Yeah, sir. Yeah, Dr. Engle, it was a very comprehensive presentation that you had made. Actually, when I started with this, I thought it would be a general structural audit, but you went up to the fatigue analysis and really the FEM analysis. It was really great watching this thing. And that's it, means further ahead to go else.
No. See, my suggestion will be, if there is any suggestion from your side, we can do more things, more better things. Because I remember when myself and Dr. Goyal will meet, my first sentence was like that. We want to create, because he was telling that these bridges first time they have given to VNIT. And we say that, okay, we'll come up with some standard procedure which includes everything.
Thing is missing in our country, and which usually in international people practice, is a model test of a bridge. Of a bridge. If any innovative things you are doing in a laboratory, they to do a scale model test.
Okay.
And they test it for all kind of load parameters and all. So that is something which is missing before constructing. Because sometimes we get a failure as a retrofitting expert. When we do a rehabilitation to the new bridges, we curse ourselves why we are doing.
Okay.
If these kind of special bridges need to be modeled and tested, so this kind of rehabilitation to the new bridges will not going to come.
Correct.
Not only model, I think Dr. Roy, they do the full scale model.
Yes. Yeah, that's why they prototype model. Yeah.
Full scale model. One is to one.
We should encourage, and we should take the data from there, and then we should correlate with the actual construction of the bridge, and then we can compare what is the things. I think, Professor, you can tell better.
See here, what happens? One more thing which I have missed actually to share. You can see frequency analysis measurement, we have shown for two spans. See, earlier what happened, we had one R&D project also here on frequency analysis of transmission line towers. See what happened, these people, they wanted to know if there is any some loose connection or anything like that. So if we measure frequency of that and analytical frequency, both has to match to certain extent. See, here what happens, we have done this frequency analysis for two spans. So both our frequency, they were quite closely matching. That means that our strength even our supporting system, everything was intact for both the spans. Actually, because of time problem, we could have done this for all the spans. See, in that case, what will happen? Suppose there are 10 span and all, suppose 8 spans, we are getting frequency, let's say 5 hertz. But other 2 spans, suppose we are getting 3 hertz. That means there is something, something is different in that particular span. So maybe I think we should add this particular thing, that frequency check should be done for all the spans experimentally. And this gives everything. Now, because if our structural system is correct, then we should get almost same frequency within 5% or 10% variation. There should not be any drastic change.
Thank you, Dr. Sir. Yes. Yeah, we have got many questions from the audience also. So
yes.
Can I say something? Professor Ingle, thank you so much for this wonderful talk. I think you've brought out the whole gamut of how an engineer has to tackle an assessment in all aspects. You know, I think that's a wonderful first step Ravindra has taken from Central Railway, and you all have gone ahead with this. The publication should be obvious. We would look forward to your publications and working with IAB. But on the other hand, I also want to tell you, to tell our audience, to take pride in the fact that Indian Railway has one of the best management systems, you know, in this country for sure. They have the most robust system. And talking about the old bridges, the robustness, the word is robustness.
Yes. Yes.
The robustness which they designed comes from two things. One is the fact that they considered a pin-jointed structure for the trusses. At least take the example of a truss. Huh. The conservativeness, not only from the working stress approach, but also from the fact that the ability of the fixed moment taking ability, which really is the real case, was not considered because they simply didn't have the tools.
Mm-hmm. You know? Yes.
And their camber calculations, all that were done in simple ways in those days. And that provided tremendous robustness, which has, the bridge has very much lived beyond its time. You know,
correct,
the design service life has been well exceeded.
Yes.
Now, think of that, you know, that innovation came well ahead of any code.
Yes.
What I want to tell everyone here is that there is no code that is required to innovate. You don't need any code. Mm-hmm.
That's
if you have the ability to innovate and justify. And today you have even tools like investigative tools like frequency domain analysis and vibration testing and things like that to get the stiffness, to characterize the structure, characterize the material, characterize the quality of construction, everything.
Yes.
So today those tools are additionally available to you. I would say, you know, with this in mind, we should look forward how to bring this more into the teaching curricula. You know, I would suggest at VNIT, the work that you all do at a more or less like an R&D level, can some of this filter down to a taught program, you know, somewhere in the engineering program? Can we sensitize our engineers to the importance of audit, assessment? And the other side, of course, is we don't have the codes for assessment in India.
Yes.
You know, the assessment versions of code, like BS5400 code of the UK, had an assessment version of the code 25 years ago, you know. So the assessment version of the code is different from the design version of the same code. The assessment version either works on the partial safety factors, derating the load side or upgrading the resistance side, because over time, these things are ameliorated. You can't use the same partial safety factors that you used at the time of original design.
Correct.
For that, we need an assessment version of the code. And in India, we don't have a single assessment version of any code for any bridge.
Yes.
So this is my appeal, that we should also think of working on this. If Railway can take the lead, I'm sure others will follow.
Yes. But as you said, curriculum-wise, I am teaching this bridge design subject since last 4 years. It was first time introduced in VNIT. Okay. And our student, almost we have got 50 students in for M.Tech. More than 40, 45 students, they take this particular course.
Good.
Of course, we cover there mainly road bridges, but we explain how to calculate moments and other things, how to use IRS code also, okay? But this particular thing, that audit and other things, it is not included in any of the curriculum till today.
We should, sir. We should start to include, at least sensitize initially, because that is a very important domain for engineering in the future.
Yes.
Also, I want to tell you, I used to come to VNIT. I used to come to VNIT sometimes to examine thesis for L.M. Gupta.
Yes. I know.
And we did a very good code on pre-stressing of steel bridges. You know?
Not
much used in India to pre-stress steel bridges.
Correct.
That's another area.
Yeah. This is only a beginning, Harsha. Actually, we have introduced the subject to VNIT now, and VNIT will definitely go ahead with the introduction of this curve.
Ravindra, any world record holder like you and me, since we worked together on bridge number 20, which was 154 meters span, it held the world record till 2 years ago when the Chinese beat us by 2 meters for a truss bridge. And that is the pride Indian Railway should have.
Okay.
And the design in India had. And that's the first time we used 3D, full 3D analysis for a railway bridge. You know, Ravindra and me were associate on that. He on the client side, me on the design side. It was a wonderful job. L&T were our contractor. So I want to tell the audience, you can have pride in the work you do.
Yes,
engineering that we do is invariably world-class many times.
So, Dr. Ingle, some of the participants, they are waiting for the answers to their questions.
Yeah. Where I can find...
Q&A,
question that is in the question answer window. If you see 22 question answers are
okay.
So you can see the questions, and I will Dr. S.K. Dhan, he is asking, why structural audit? What is the outcome of fatigue analysis? How is the old bridge functioning well after, well, even after 100 years of old? I think this answer has been given.
Correct.
Just to give a kind of confidence, it's like a full body scan after a period, after a period of say 40 years of age or like that. So we have done with that purpose to gain a confidence about the strength of the bridge. And the outcome of fatigue analysis, we have found it's well, it's okay. And the old bridges are functioning because they are found safe structurally.
Correct.
So there should not be any issue. Then another question by the same, by Mr. Likhon Biswas. Hum bridge, the girder is considered simply supported, but how you cater the effective intermediate cross frame location for asymmetrical load? Well, I don't think there is any asymmetrical load coming
There is no asymmetrical load.
So this question is that way not is answered automatically. Then what is the significance of frequency checking of bridge? Only vertical seismic analysis is sufficient or not? I think this is a academician kind of a job done by Professor Ingle. It was not in the scope, but he has done it out of his curiosity and we welcome it. He has done a very good job by doing this analysis also.
Correct.
So that's good. So please explain UCR pier. UCR is, I think it is coarse rubble masonry pier.
Correct.
UCR is probably universal coarse rubble.
Yes.
If I'm not wrong. Usually uncoarse rubble and coarse rubble. There are two kinds of masonry structures.
Yes.
It is basically the coarse rubble masonry pier.
Yes.
So another question in Vuna Bridge, the deflection calculations, how the young modulus is estimated from almost 100 years old. This is as per the standard E value.
Standard E value.
Right. How do the corrosion analysis? This is again, you have taken 1.5 mm corrosion.
Correct.
So this is also answered. Then again, same Likhon Biswas sir, puchte hain, as picture Irai Bridge is semi-through, open web girder. How the compression element is restrained against lateral buckling? I think this is a question which you can answer.
Yeah. Actually, see what happened in code also, it is given how to calculate the strength of this particular, that member. Okay. With the deflection, which we have done because since this was just informative, because in our design calculation, it is there. Okay. See what happened. It is a, this particular thing, it is not having any compression thing. Okay, this cross girder. So formulation is there for that to calculate the deflection and to get the effective length of that. Effective length will be very high for that particular case. Okay. See, it is given. Even in IRS code also, it is given. Okay. How to calculate that for lateral buckling, it is given in IRS code also.
Okay.
Yes.
The next question is Gautam Jha. What is the reference for considering section reduction for corrosion allowance? He's asking the IS code.
No, see, it was in earlier IS code 800. Code says that, okay, we should take 1.5 mm corrosion allowance. Even many of this this waste treatment engineering people, they take 1.5 mm allowance. So we started with that. We don't have any solid reason. Okay. See, somebody may take 2 mm also. Okay. But since 1.5 mm, I was remembering. So we took 1.5 mm allowance here.
Can I add to that, sir?
Yes.
That is for the sake of taking for the first analysis. If somebody is in doubt, he can go for the actual measurement of the corrosion.
Yes.
And that would be the most realistic thing. But that is the second stage.
Yes, you are safe
by assuming this 1.5 mm, say 2 mm, then there is no need of going further to verify it.
Correct.
I think that's a good way.
Yeah.
Then Mr. Omkar Kumbhar is asking how to measure the dimensions of the section on site on actual structure, because most of the time accessibility is the main limitation. Actually, this is to be ensured by railway.
Railway, yes.
And arranging traffic blocks.
Correct.
And this is meticulous. This is done. There is no issue about
it.
How to integrate the jacking of masonry pier with old pier? How to integrate the jacking?
Jacketing.
Okay. This is by way of doveling, actually.
Dovel bars.
There is a standard RDSO drawing for that.
Yes.
It is ensured by following that drawing with dovels. Then Arvind Kumar Singh is asking, preliminary structure audit report of all above open wheel girders received from VNIT in Nagpur, in which is recommended for strengthening of members of trust, where interaction ratio exceeds 0.85.
Correct.
Clause 3.3.9 of RS Steel Bridge Code, all open wheel girders for railway bridges span 30.5 meter and above shall be pre-stressed. This pre-stressing force is not being considered in design. However, as per clause itne of RS Steel Bridge Code, in case of pre-stressed girder, deformation stress may be ignored. That is true. Whatever he's saying is true. So, but I suppose we ignore all the pre-stressing, although we do, but that is for the new bridges.
Yes.
In old bridges, we do not know whether the pre-stressing has been done or not. So we have to just ignore it and we have to do simple analysis.
Yes.
I think we can discuss it later on. He is probably from our headquarter only. So we will discuss with him separately also if there is any pending doubt. Then Mr. Omkar Kumbhar, how to design RC jacketing of masonry pier? Actually, iska answer bhi hi hai. We have got a standard design, standard drawing of RDSO. By doveling, and then we follow the same principle. Depending upon the height of the structure, we decide the thickness.
Correct. Yes.
Again, Arvind Kumar Singh is asking preliminary structural report of.
I think it is same
question. Okay. As per report, jacketing is recommended due to tension in stone masonry under earthquake loading. Under codal provision, tension zone should be neglected. I think Mr. AK Singh can be asked to contact you on one-to-one basis. He has
Yes, definitely.
We will do that.
Correct.
To take others, Omkar Kumbhar is again, how can we create design drawing of RC and PSC bridges? Same problem, availability of drawing has been observed and due to running electrical line measurements are also not possible in ROP. So this is a question which we have to ponder on.
See what happened here. We have taken measurement close to abutment. Where there was no problem of this particular electric or anything like that. Okay. Of course, maybe, I don't know, some bridges, it may be difficult. Okay.
Then,
but we didn't face much difficulty in doing the measurements.
Actually, his question is, if there is a PSC bridge, and the drawing is not available, then what can we do?
Then it is very difficult because, see, this Ajni bridge, we have got same problem. It is a RCC, concrete. But then what happens? We have taken only concrete dimensions and we have not gone further checking of that reinforcement and other things because we have to stop somewhere now. If information is available, then we could have gone for that also. And what we have heard that even in those girders, even steel I sections, they were embedded. Okay. Because one of the bridge which has been dismantled near Nagpur railway station, that shows that I girders were there inside the girder. Okay. And similar bridge, this Ajni bridge similar to that.
Okay. Okay, now Mr. Kumar Janendra, he's asking what is the impact of crack developed with respect to depth in pier? That is probably under the bedding stone.
Yes. It is basically for that bedding stone.
Yeah.
Okay, yes.
Okay, there's no severe...
No, yes.
Thank you. Yeah. Then Paresh Vishnoi, all these are of quite old bridges with insufficient drawings and structural deterioration. Did you consider cross-checking analytical structural frequencies with measured FFT analysis over accelerometer sensors.
We have done that. Okay. Okay. That has been done. That's why.
So that will be in your report.
Correct. Yes.
Sachin, any guideline for audit? Yes, we have issued, Central Railway had issued one guideline for audit, and probably we would be expanding on that. And as we have discussed in IIV, we would be doing some improvement over that and will be issuing that.
Okay, yes.
Alok Bhomik saab pooch rahe hain, excellent presentation by Engineer Ingle. Thank you very much, Bhomik saab. Just one question. Are these masonry substructures checked for current?
Yes. For all the four things are checked for current.
Very nice, yes. Sir. Thank you. And DSR Murthy, vibration measurements done by portable instrument or sensors? Professor DSR Murthy, Andhra University, Visakhapatnam.
It is, see, that instrument name and other things, everything I have mentioned in my presentation.
Okay.
Yes.
Then the standard checklist can be prepared for general guidance uniformly.
Yes, again, yes.
Same guideline that is
correct.
That will be given. Central Railway has got one that can be immediately given by you.
Correct.
Likhon Bishwas again. I think for lateral load like wind load or seismic or train, the train wheel interaction, train wheel reaction will be different, which create a asymmetrical load. And one side footpath load also create asymmetrical loading.
Yes. Yeah, something, but this we are not considered. Okay.
So you can keep in mind.
Yes, definitely.
Thank you, Mr. Vishwas. Yes. Your suggestion is well taken. Thank you.
Yes.
So with that, we are through with all the questions. If there is any other question, we can reply it on email. You can exchange.
Yes.
Thank you. So now it is over to Dr. Gopal Rai.
Yes, sir. One request is there to all the participants and all. They should become IIB members. Okay, it is very important that we are doing every month two or three lectures, and there will be more. And you can refer to our technical papers, or 30,000 papers are there on the website. Once you become a member, then only you can access to that the technical papers. And for the students, especially discounts are there. So I request all of you to become a IIB member. A lot of benefits are there. And this is only the message I got from the office, from the chairman and president, from the MD, DG and president. Over to Ruhi, I think. Thank you, Engineer Boyle.
General Secretary, Dipte Saab, if he can say something.
Yeah, Dipte sir, DG sir. Dipte sir, are you there?
Hello.
Ah, namaskar sir.
Namaskar. Dr. Ingle has covered very nicely, excellent presentation, and he has done detailed analysis, detailed study. It is very, very good presentation. I am very happy about railway bridges, the way he has collected the data and analyzed and presented. My one inquiry to Engineer Ravindra Kumar Goyal.
Yes, sir.
Here, you said that no drawings are available for all your 14 bridges. Have you selected only 14 bridges, these 14 bridges where drawings are not available? Or really in Central Railway, there are no drawings for any of the bridges?
No, sir. drawings, structural drawings means the detailed structural drawings. Otherwise, general drawings are available, but detailed structural drawings are not available. So it's we have not selected based on that consideration. The considerations were age, come importance actually. But this was known during the analysis that the drawings are not available.
Achha. Sir. Now, very, very good effort. Very good effort by Central Railway as well as Dr. Ingle. And we hope that the such type of studies continue further and bring out the detailed studies for each and every bridge. Thank you very much. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for your blessings.
Thank you.
Thank you, DG sir. Now it's time to hand over to Ruhi. I think she will do the lead pool for Vodafone.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, sir. To all honorable. Ruhi,
आपके बोलने के पहले, Ruhi जी, आपके बोलने के पहले एक चीज बोलना चाहूँगा सभी को. I was traveling today in Patna, Bihar. Okay.
तो एक अच्छी चीज पढ़ी मैंने वहां पे, गांधी आश्रम के बाहर लिखा हुआ था कि सब कुछ अपना अपने कर्म जो है वो भगवान को दे दो, क्योंकि जो आप जिंदगी भर नहीं कर सकते हो तो भगवान एक पल में कर सकता है। तो जो भी आप काम कर रहे हैं यू शुड स्टे टू द 100% इन द फेवर ऑफ गॉड, और जो हम जिंदगी भर नहीं कर सकते हो एक पल में भगवान कर सकते हैं। विद दिस आई विल हैंड ओवर टू रूबी जी, ओवर टू यू।
थैंक यू सर। To all honorable dignitaries, it's my privilege to have been asked to propose a formal vote of thanks for our special lecture 14 series. I, on behalf of IIBE, extend a very hearty vote of thanks to all the members and non-members for gracing us with your presence and sharing with us your valuable feedback and suggestions. Firstly, I would like to thanks to our Director General, Engineer DG Dutesir, for always providing us with a vision for the future of IIBE. Our President, Engineer Vinay Gupta, for constantly guiding, motivating, and inspiring us to achieve the vision. I would like to thank our Treasurer, Mr. P.R. Kilkar, for being a strong support of IIBE. Our Honorary Secretary, Engineer Swapnil Joshi, for always managing this platform. Our Honorary Secretary, Dr. Gopal Rai, always guiding us with his humorous side. I would like to thanks to our today's speaker, Dr. R.K. Engle, for his enlightening and entertaining presentation and for sharing his valuable opinion in this platform. I would like to thanks to our today's moderator, engineer R.K. Goyal, for managing this webinar on this forum. I would like to thanks to our eminent executive committee members for their valuable presence and support. I would like to thanks Deepika, coordinator of IIBE, for always helping and managing all the events of this. Last but not the least, Mr. Hozafa, for all his IT support. Also to all the participants for always coming in huge number to make this webinar a great success. Thank you. With this permission of our Director General, for closing the session. Thank you.
Thank you, Ruhi.
Thank you, Ravindra.
This is structural audit. This is structural audit. This is first step. We have to go many kilometers.
Yes.
Nice to go. This excellent, is
a excellent moderation, Ravindra. Excellent. Thank you. It was very enjoyable.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. And it is suggested by Engineer Goyal sir only.
Excellent.
The English sir reference. Very good, sir. This is a good step. I think
the beginning only, sir. We have to go long.
Yes.
No, no. This is the first step, sir. This is the first step.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Wonderful.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye, bye, everybody.
Thank you. Bye. Thank you.